In the waters of baptism, Jim died with Christ and rose with him a new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Let us stand. Good morning, everyone, and welcome to St. Anne's this morning as we come to celebrate our funeral service for the life of Jim. And we gather here and we gather on holy ground. We stand on holy ground, whether it's inside the church or those who are outside the church and are engaging with us nevertheless. So we come as a family of faith. We stand on holy ground in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And the grace and the peace of God, whose Father, the love of Jesus the Christ, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. I welcome you all, especially those who have travelled a distance to be with Margaret and the family here this morning. Those of other churches or no church, you're very welcome. Thank you for being with us today. So we gather with Margaret, Patricia and Joseph and Eileen, with Jim's grandchildren, Emma and Jimmy, Beth, Cecilia, Sarah and Ben, with his son-in-law Tim and daughter-in-law Jeanette, with sisters Bridie and Molly and the extended family. So it's a family service of remembrance, of love. So let us pray. My brothers and sisters, we have come together to renew our trust in Christ, who by dying on the cross has freed us from eternal death, and by rising has opened for us the gates of heaven. Let us pray for our brother Jim, that he may share in Christ's victory. Let us pray also for ourselves this morning, that the Lord may grant us the gift of his loving consolation. So let us pray in silence. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain death that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery your servant Jim, who has gone to his rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, for ever and ever. I invite you all now to be seated, and I invite Jeanette to share God's word with us now.
First reading, a reading from the book of Revelation. I, John, heard a voice from heaven say to me, write down, happy are those who die in the Lord. Happy indeed. The Spirit says, now they can rest forever after their work, since their good deeds go with them. The word is the Lord.
Thanks be to God. I'd like to invite Vanessa to share God's word with us.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Let us love one another, for love is of God, and he who loves is born of God and knows God. He who does not love does not know God, for God is love. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world so that we might live through him. In this is love, not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son to be the expiation for our sins. If God so loved us, we ought also to love one another. No man has ever seen God. If we love one another, God abides in us, and his love is perfected in us. In this is love perfected in us, that we may have confidence for the day of judgment. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Let us stand. Thank you. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatever you ask of God, he will grant you." "Your brother," said Jesus to her, "will rise again." Martha said, "I know he will rise again at the resurrection on the last day." Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and the life. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, he will live, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she said. "I believe that you are the Christ, the Son of God, the one who is to come into this world." The Gospel of the Lord. Please be seated for a few minutes. We've come here today to share in the sorrow of this family, to be with Margaret, Patricia, Joseph and Eileen and all the family as they experience this pain and the loss of Jim, a husband, a father, a granddad, a brother, a friend, a colleague. We've come to express our sympathy, and it's always difficult to find words because words are kind of so often go across the top of our heads. But our very presence here today is an expression of our sympathy. And in coming here today, we're doing what Jesus himself did when he heard about his friend Lazarus. He went to be with Mary and Martha, to be with them. Just to be with them. Our presence is a Christ-like thing. Our presence is the right thing to do as the followers of Jesus. As followers of Jesus, as a Christian people, we weep with those who weep. Yeah. And St. Paul tells us, of course, that we should not grieve as others do who have no hope. Because we grieve as a people of hope. That doesn't mean that hope takes away the pain or the loss. It doesn't give us an escape from the sadness of death. But we believe that behind the sorrow, behind the pain, the loss, we believe that Jim is in God's hands. We believe that Jim is with God. And God is very, very near. So we grieve with hope. And our Easter candle that burns before us this morning reminds us that Jesus died and rose again. That death is not the end. That Christ has overcome death. And that when we die, we enter into Christ's full life in eternity. If anyone has believed in Christ, even though they die, yet shall they live. So our grief has that underlying current of peace. Because we have a life that is already free from death. And those who die in Christ have entered a life that is fuller, a life that is more glorious than we have ever experienced. That's a life that began for Jim, you know, way back some 77 years ago in the West, in that beautiful place of lakes in Fermanagh, Edirne. Going to school there and working on different farms, working in the garage as a mechanic, and learned to drive the digger in Irvinstown, you know, and then the move to Belfast, and whether it be Eastwoods or Farrans or Tinnelly's or the Kilroot Power Station, you know, a demolition expert. Yeah, buildings, not people. Yeah, because Jim's first love, of course, was Margaret, whom they met at a carnival dance in Trillick, I believe. And they married in 65. Met at a dance. Jim loved dancing. jiving, swinging around the room. A man of music too, the bagpipes, tin whistle, mouth organ, accordion, any band he played in, you know. But the man who was happiest when he was pottering away in the shed, in his own garage there, you know. The DIY man, fixing something or other, making something, fixing the car, you know. I'm told that he recently supervised the laying of slabs in Patricia's back, and him with the oxygen mask strapped to his back, still overseeing, supervising, making sure it was going to be done right. Yeah, that was Jim. Yeah, pottering about. That was Jim's holiday. That was the expression that was used in the house. Always busy, doing things, tinkering. Always loving Margaret, his best wife. Yeah, best looking. Isn't that what he said? Yeah, loving his children, Joseph, Patricia, and Eileen. You know, loving his grandchildren. And they loved to see Grandad Jim. And he enjoyed their company. It was great fun with them. Wonderful memories created. Always remembering good times. Beautiful treasures of togetherness and family. A home, a place of acceptance, a place of welcome. And now we who are left behind, you know, feel that kind of emptiness. But for Jim, there's no more sickness. There's no more gasping for breath. There's no more sadness for him. Our prayer is that he will be remembered among those who have been raised to that new life, the fullness of Christ's life. That's the light in which you and I hope. You know? And that we who are left alive will eventually be caught up in that new life with Christ and meet Jim again. Eternal rest grant unto Jim, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. May he rest in peace, and may his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Now I invite you to stand, and we have our prayers of intercession, and I would ask and invite Jimmy to lead us in those prayers this morning. God the Almighty Father raised Christ his Son from the dead, so with confidence now we ask him to save all his people, living and dead.
For James, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all of those who have helped us, that they may now be given the reward of their goodness, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For all here present, that our remembrance of James may be a source of comfort and strength to us, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For doctors, nurses and carers, particularly those who were so good to James in the last months of his life, in particular Catherine and Eleanor, may they have kind hearts and gentle hands. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us. God, our shelter and our strength, you listen in love to the cry of all your people. Hear the prayers we offer for all our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption. We ask all this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now let us bring all our prayers together as we pray to the Father using the words that Jesus himself gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Jim, and now we come to the last farewell. There's always sadness and parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Jim again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. So let's console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Let us now pray in silence for Jim. And as we do so, we'll honour his remains with sprinkling of holy water, a reminder that it is in the waters of baptism, when we were baptised, that we become children of the Father, brothers and sisters to each other. We'll honour his remains with the sweet-smelling incense, a reminder that our bodies are the temples of God's Holy Spirit, that God lives within each one of us, that our bodies are precious. So let's pray in silence for Jim. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Haste, saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ who called you take you to himself. May the angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto Jim, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. To you, Lord, we commend the soul of Jim, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, may Jim live forever. Forgive whatever sins he committed through human weakness. And in your goodness, grant him everlasting peace and rest. We ask this through Christ our Lord. In peace now, let us take our brother Jim to his place of rest. Thank you.